Barbara Angela Miller, aka Vocal Angel. And today is day 21 of my 21 days live stream challenge. And boy, you've seen the challenges. It has been a challenge, but I have been showing up for women 50 and over just to talk about personal identity, realigning with self, and prosperity and wealth and reFirement, not retirement. So before I go any further, I am going to just breathe a word of prayer, inviting Almighty God into our space and into what He wants to say today. Dear Heavenly Father, there is none like You. Thank You for Your keeping cares and Your tender mercies towards us. I thank You, Lord, that as I've come to the end of my live stream challenge, I thank You for giving me the grace, the strength, the ability to be able to do what You purposed in my heart to do. And it's all because of You. I love people, love social media, and I'm here just to speak up, speak with my voice, and encourage others to do the same. So thank You, Father, for hearing me now. And what I fail of asking You, don't fail to grant it as I look to You and tell You thanks. In Jesus' name, amen. I'm here. I'm showing up for women 50 and over. And why? Because this is that time. It's a kind of a transition period, as I've been saying in my live stream, where we're full of experience, full of dreams, full of hope. Some maybe not full of hope. Some are just thinking, what am I going to do for retirement? Where am I going to get the income to sustain me for retirement? You know, I went to AI. I'm using the word retirement a lot. What does it mean? So I popped into Perplexity and just asked a question. I said, what is retirement and where did it originate? Well, I might not go into where it originated from, but retirement is the process of leaving one's job or ceasing to work after reaching a certain age or due to health reasons. It often involves withdrawing from active working life, either fully or partially, by reducing work hours. Many people retire when they are eligible for pension benefits, which can be either private or public. So the pension benefits really supposed to help to fund that stage of life where you're no longer able, where you're no longer able to actively work, you know, like how you used to. But before, it said people used to work until they couldn't work anymore. But then I find that you can, I've looked into it, you can actually reach retirement age, get your pension, and some people not too long after, they die because they're now inactive and we're not meant to be inactive. So what are we meant to be doing? I think we're meant to be fulfilling our heart's desires and serving each other while we're here on earth. And I don't think there's a retirement for that. What you have to do is refire. But then you're going to say, but I don't want to work. No, but you do need funding to be able to do the things you really want to do. And when I was thinking about our age group and, you know, what the responsibilities that we have, and sometimes we think we're really heading downwards, but a scripture popped into my head that relates a lot to refinement. And it's found in Isaiah 40 verse, it's the King James Version, Isaiah 40 verse, I'm going to start from 30. Actually, I'm going to start from verse 28. It says, has thou not known, has thou not heard that the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, fainteth not, neither is weary. There is no searching of his understanding. He giveth power to the faint, and to them that have no might, he increases strength. He says in verse 30, even the youths have faint and be weary, and young men shall utterly fall, but they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Isn't that amazing? That applies to anyone that thinks that they're weary. God is saying, I don't get tired, and so I can give you strength. I don't get weary. So if you're doing things and you're weary and you're coming to that stage where you need some help, some grace, he says the young men, they will faint. But those of us who wait upon the Lord, we will run and not be weary. There is no retirement, just refinement. He said you will renew your strength. What do you want your strength to be renewed for? To serve, to feel of value, to create wealth, legacy, leave an inheritance. That's what we need our strength for. To fund things that, you know, we really want to fund. To be productive, to be fruitful and multiply. You're going to need strength for that. So he says, they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint. There's no giving up. There's no retirement. What we need is to refuel, realign, renew our strength through the Lord. And you have to have a good reason for your strength to be renewed. Do you have health? You have strength, you have breath, your heart's beating. What do we do with those assets that God has blessed us with? What are we doing with them? Now, to create wealth, there is God's way, and there is also a system that does work. But you can get riches, as I said yesterday. I think I posed a question a couple of days ago. And I made the statement, I said, you can be rich and not be wealthy, but you can't be wealthy and not be rich. And I also said, you can be rich and not be wise at all, but you cannot be wise and not be rich. You say, so those of us who claim that we're wise and we have the wisdom of God, wealth comes with it. I read it in Proverbs. I read the scripture, and it said that it has long life, wisdom, because the Bible tells us wisdom is the principal thing. And in all you're getting, get understanding. So when you get wisdom, it says wisdom has long life in her right hand, and in her left hand she has riches and honor. So it pays for us to seek the wisdom of God. It pays for us to do things God's way. And God's way has a system. The world can tap into certain aspects of it, but they won't be complete. You see lots of rich people that are miserable. Lots of rich people that don't have health. So we need to have balance. We need to be in alignment with the will of God. And so what we realize that there are certain principles to building wealth, specifically in the kingdom. I mentioned it before. When you give to the poor, you lend to God and he will reward you. I mentioned that Jesus and the disciples, they did some trading and people were shocked. But what do you think? Because I mentioned that Judas said about the oil that was poured on his feet. He said, this is like a year's wages. This could have been sold and given to the poor. Why would he be telling Jesus that? And Jesus didn't say, we don't sell. He said, no, 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 the poor you're going to have with you always. But this woman, she's anointing me for my burial. So the poor are here for us to give to. That's one of the principles of creating wealth. Another one is community. We give to the cause. We give to each other. We form communities. And I said when the early church kicked off, they sold their houses and laid the money at the apostles' feet. I mentioned another concept that we need to learn to sell. Told the rich ruler, sell what you have and give to the poor and come follow me. I mentioned Elijah helping out that widow. The oil that was in all those containers, he says, go and sell it now and pay off your debt. You can't not know how to sell. That's a part of strategy. But now that new technology has come, there's a way to create wealth faster. And some people buy into it. I buy into the blockchain and artificial intelligence. I think you cannot ignore it. It's growing exponentially. And if we don't get into the space of the blockchain or artificial intelligence, quantum computing, the metaverse, Web 3.0, the internet has moved on. Once upon a time, we used to say online. Now we're going to be saying, or ought to be saying, on chain, on the blockchain, because assets are moving into that space. That's the space that we can begin to create wealth in a decentralized environment. It's a technology that the governments are going to be using, but they're going to use it in a centralized environment to track you. But there is a decentralized space. And to get into that environment, you start with your digital wallet. And I think it's one of the easiest things for us women to enter into that space. And I'll show you how to get that digital wallet and how we can use that system, a system, to create wealth where we open and we donate to each other through the wallets. That's a space because of the blockchain. Any transaction that takes place on the blockchain, it cannot be fiddled with, right? Because it's done in blocks and verified in blocks. Quite an interesting environment where people can't really cheat you on the blockchain. You have scrupulous people. There are rules you have to obey, yes? You have passwords and things like that. You don't tell people your passwords. These are just common sense things. And people will trick people into giving them passwords. Do you have your wallet? You know, you need to know how to look after things. And one of the big things that I talked about was investment. And we're not taught to invest in school. In school, we are schooled. Yes, we are taught to be employees. We're taught to regurgitate stuff. You learn stuff. Yes, and put it back out in an exam. Not even being creative with our minds, and God has made us to be creative. But then, I know I heard this thing back in Jamaica once, and the expression was, those who get A's and B's in school, they are employed by those who get the D's and the E's and the F's. Interesting, isn't it? Yeah, we're meant really to be creatives. Create wealth. And there's a system right now where things can be done faster. Technology is here to aid us. And I want to bring a group of women, 50 and over, into that space to be able to do some amazing things on the blockchain, to form a community, one where we give to each other, which is one of the principles of God, giving. And we can't go wrong in certain things. So this is my last stream, live stream. And I hope I've encouraged you ladies to do something amazing. Yes, I'll most probably put my webpage where you can download my report that I did about the myths about cryptocurrency. And so that we can educate ourselves and move into that space and don't get left behind. I kept saying that if we don't go into that space and use the technology, then we're going to be governed by those who entered that space and used it. So don't, you know, don't let it AI, you know, use us. Let us use AI and get familiar and get and do what we need to do. Don't be frightened. Don't be scared. And trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not to your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him and he will direct your path. And so we know that we're building. There are principles. Unless the Lord builds the house, they labor in vain that build it. Unless he watches over the city, the watchman, he watches in vain. So I truly hope that my message about our personal identity, wealth creation, prosperity, the blockchain, cryptocurrency is getting through and you're getting interested and excited to want to know more and to learn more. I know I'm a bit weak. Remember, I'm on day 7 on my 21 days Daniel fast. Amazing. I'm looking forward to that advancement. Okay, I hope that encourages you to look into it and to draw nearer to God and to seek his wisdom and his strength and his power. So I truly hope this was a blessing to you. So join me, community, women 50 and over. I will take you places. Search me out on Instagram, Barbara Original Miller. And I'm also Vocal Angel ID on Instagram. I'm also on Facebook, Barbara Williams Miller. And I'm also on Facebook page, which is Vocal Angel Limited. So join me, join the fun, join the adventure as I just encourage you all and say bye for now. Bye. Oh, I normally say be blessed.